If you watch too much YouTube, you might know that 1 plus 2 plus 3, etc. equals negative 1 12th. Well, for some definition of equals. In this case, Ramanujan summation. I'll put an R over the equals. In short, we all know that this sum actually diverges to infinity, but we can follow a procedure to ignore the infinities and isolate a constant term. But why do we end up with negative 1 12th? At first glance, it makes absolutely no sense. Let's start with the sum for 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to n. There's a general formula to evaluate this, n times n plus 1 divided by 2. I'll call this sum function s of n. Let's plot this function. Here's the first strange thing. The area under the axis here, that is the integral between n equals minus 1 and 0, is, drumroll please, negative 1 12th. But what does this mean? The sum of a negative number of integers doesn't really make sense. So let's think about this as a special case of a more general fact. The area under any unit width of this function is half n squared minus 1 12th. The yellow bit is just the n equals 0 case. Let me explain where that comes from. I'll consider an arbitrary part of the curve between n minus 1 and n. First, take a straight line approximation. The function value on the left is half n squared minus half n, and the function value on the right is half n squared plus half n. The average is half n squared, so the orange area is half n squared. If that's not obvious, we can just take this top triangle and flip it over. Then we have to subtract the area of this parabolic segment, which is 1 12th for any n. We can show that geometrically. There's a formula for the area between a parabola and a chord. I wanted to show you this because it gives you an intuition for where the minus 1 12th is coming from. It's coming from the curvature of the sum function. And that curvature, loosely speaking, is also what's being extracted by the Ramanujan summation. If we look at what Ramanujan does, he uses the Euler-Maclaurin formula to expand the sum, and then he ignores all the terms that depend on n, which are assumed to diverge. So what he's left with is these constant terms that depend on the function value and derivatives at the lower limit. For our function, this term is 0, and this term is negative 1 12th. But this is in terms of the sum and function f, and not the sum function s that we were looking at before. Not to worry, we know s can be defined like this, so we can rearrange for f and substitute that in, and we can do the same for derivatives because of the linearity of differentiation. What is this now? Well, actually, if we write down an Euler-Maclaurin expansion for s, this is these two terms, so we can rearrange and substitute in. Then this term is 0, and finally we have the yellow area we showed before. So we've come full circle to show how this area here is related to the Ramanujan sum, and hopefully gained a bit of intuition about how the negative 1 12th is connected to the shape of the function. As usual, there's more detail in my blog post, and I'll also provide some links below.